I can't believe the day is finally here. These past 4 years have been the best of my life. In the beginning of August 2015, we started a relationship that has now grown into a marriage. So I wanted to end this letter with how much I appreciate our love for each other and everything that makes you who you are. We are a perfect couple and really balance each other out in the most positive of ways. I love you, babe, and can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. Let's enjoy today and all of our loved ones as we continue our journey in this relationship. I'm so happy to now be able to call you my wife.
I am for once speechless. I woke up this morning and said, I cannot believe this. Our big day is finally here, babe, a year and a half later. We made it. All the endless nights will now be filled with love as we can enjoy each other as husband and wife moving forward. I am so excited, nervous, anxious, but overall happy for today that words cannot describe. I knew when I met you in high school, there was something about you, but little did I know, almost 20 years later, here we are. The fairy tale I always dreamt about growing up is finally coming true, and I wouldn't want it to be with anybody else but you, baby. This is the start of the next chapter in our lives together, and I am excited to go through each and every hurdle with you. I am ready to be your wife and continuously find time for each other no matter what life throws at us or how crazy I can be sometimes. It's the damn Cuban in me, babe, but I will stop rambling, and bottom line is today is our day and the beginning to our new life together. Let's celebrate and enjoy every bit of it. Remember, we are in charge, and let's make it a night we will never forget. We deserve it. I am dying for a honeymoon, and today starts the countdown until we will be in St. Lucia with our toes in the sand and without a care in the world. Until then, let's get married.
rise. Let's welcome the bride. Here today to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, a marriage. We want to recognize the worth and beauty of love and to add our best wishes to Vanessa and Ryan, who have chosen to be united to each other in holy marriage. There are no obligations on earth sweeter or more tender, no vows more important than these that are about to be assumed today. There's no human institution more important than the home to our society. The Bible says God is love, and marriage was His idea, His best gift to mankind. This is the chosen day for us to celebrate the marriage of Vanessa Gillen and Ryan Joseph Deeney. Enjoy the pleasure and privilege that are ours today to witness this celebration of love. My duty requires me to ask, who blesses this woman to marry this man?
You? I do.
A little louder now.
I do.
Thank you so much. Before we take our seats, let's do something. As we worked on the details of this great day, they told me that we'd have a very special group of people here today to celebrate with them. And so since there are so many of you friends who are associates and relatives and maybe workmates and us just who admire this dear couple, I want to ask you each a question. Do you intend to give this dear couple your support, prayers, and words of encouragement? If so, please respond with a very warm, "We do."
We do.
Thank you so much. You may be seated. There are some really special people up front here with us. This is the most individuals I've ever had up front with me. This is so special. I told Ryan and Vanessa that they have broken a record for me, for which I am very grateful. They have chosen to light the two outer candles. May I just say, in all reverence, good luck. It's been done twice, but there's a great symbolism that's going to be done here. Let's go over and light the candles, because they're symbolically showing that two become one. Because later on, they'll probably have to relight the candles, and they will join the two candles into one light, which will represent their life together.
The key to love is understanding, as it is the little things that say so much by themselves. The key to love is forgiveness, to accept each other's faults and pardon mistakes. The key to love is sharing. Sharing and facing your good fortunes as well as the bad, together, both conquering problems, forever searching for ways to intensify your happiness, and by giving in but never giving up. The key to love is respect. Respect realizing that you are two separate people with different ideas, that you don't belong to each other, that you belong with each other and share a mutual bond. The key to love is inside us all. It takes time and patience to unlock all the ingredients that will take you to its threshold. It is the continual learning process that demands a lot of work, but the rewards are more than worth the effort, and that is the key to love.
Thank you so much, Ernesto. Thank you. Words well chosen for these dear
people here today. And just a few more words about love. To marry is one of the most important decisions anyone will ever make. And you all today are upholding the institution of marriage, which is increasingly discredited in our society. Holy wedlock. I married Beth 43 years ago, and it was the best decision that I've ever made. She's truly a helper fitting for me. Please understand, though, that no marriage can last without unconditional love. You will need kindness, trust, dedication, forgiveness, faith, and follow-through to stay true in the journey for the long haul. Never take each other for granted. Don't compare with others. Then, when you are like me, old, I pray that you will be still found hand in hand, thankful for each other, always treating each other with tenderness, kindness, and respect. Another word or two about love. The more like philosophical words. To love is to create an oasis of tranquility for one another. Now, this building, this place is a special space set apart for wonderful events like weddings. Marriage creates a special space in your lives where you can be together in a quiet and safe place apart from others and just enjoy one another. And, you know, you won't need to pretend and put on airs and try to impress the other because you already know that you're already lovingly accepted by each other. To make marriage work, it takes work to make marriage work. Unconditional love chooses to hold true to the journey for a lasting and successful commitment. A psychologist named Will Meek contrasts two kinds of love when he says, romantic love is when we have this consuming emotional experience, and it usually lasts about a year and a half. Deep love comes after we see how imperfect the other is, and we commit afresh to him or her anyway. So yes, first love, a Bible term, first love must be zealously maintained. So I personally recommend to you that you pray that you trust God, because he alone can help us to make it through to a successful conclusion. And you know, husbands are told by the Apostle Paul, love your wife like Christ loved the church. He died for us to win us to himself. So I want to challenge you to love like this. It's pretty easy to love someone who does nice things for us, right? Pretty easy to love someone that we respect and admire. But there's something that goes far beyond the words, I love you if, or I love you because. Unconditional love is in a class apart. It says, I love you anyway. I will love you always, no matter what. Pastor Rick Warren, one of my personal heroes, says that a great marriage is the union of two great forgivers. Pause and ponder that for a little bit. Two great forgivers. Let's face it, we all make mistakes. We drop the ball. We blow it. But love says to the other person, I forgive you, I still love you, and I will stay with you the rest of my life. So they are committing today to a long love together in the same direction. How would you like to know a little more about their love story? They grew up in Addison, Illinois, and met in 1999 at Addison Trail High School. I asked them what they enjoy, traveling the world. They visited Mexico, the Bahamas, Jamaica, and the Grand Cayman Islands. They like to wine and dine, and they love Chicago team sports events. I asked about the proposal. Maybe some of you don't know about this. He proposed to her in the Bahamas in January of 2018. They were on the beach at sunrise walking along the water. What is it that they especially love and appreciate about each other? She says, I appreciate Ryan's patience, kind heart, thoughtfulness, and dedication to me, and he appreciates her generosity, diligence, and just being ambitious and passionate in life. Well, their plans to have a puppy, hopefully by the end of this year, one or two kids in the future, and continued travel to the rest of the world, including Europe, Hawaii, and Thailand. That's awesome. Enjoy, you guys. Enjoy. And now they've chosen to exchange their vows. I will steal these from you. Get ready, prepare your hearts to say these vows, which will be so meaningful to you. Ryan, as you look into the eyes of this beautiful woman, and please, if you don't mind, hold hands. Thank you. Please repeat after me, Ryan. I, Ryan.
Take you, Vanessa.
To be my wife. I promise to give the best of myself to you. And continue to be. Each other's biggest fans. I will listen to you with compassion. And speak to you with encouragement. I will remain faithful to you. Share in your dreams. Promise you my time. Dedication and attention. And be the best husband I can. I promise to love you. In good times and bad. In sickness and in health. To love and cherish. As long as we both shall live. And now, Vanessa, sweetie, it's your turn. Please repeat after me. I, Vanessa. Give you my heart, Ryan. Since you are my husband. I will love you. Respect you. I promise my time and attention. To have and to hold you. From this day forward. I promise you my dedication. In better or bad circumstances. I will be true to you. For better or worse. In sickness and health. I want to grow old with you. To love and cherish you. As long as we both shall live. They're very symbolic of the union that's occurring here today. They're circular shaped, speaks of wholeness, completeness, and permanence, and unbroken circle of love. So wear them with pride and joy. Please give her, Ryan, the ring. And then repeat after me. Sometimes the ladies help the men, right?
There's a couple on here, so you know.
I'm loving it. These are beautiful. Oh, man. Don't cry. Well, I guess it's permitted to cry. It's beautiful. Okay, please, Brian, repeat after me.
Yes.
As I give you this ring. I give you my heart.
I give it to you.
And pledge to be true.
And love you.
As long as I live. And now, dear Vanessa, we're going to try this thing, guys. As I give you this ring.
I give you my heart.
I give it to you. And pledge to be true. And love you.
As long as I live.
Excellent. Please remember these words and actions and live accordingly. And now for the unity candle. Fantastic. You have chosen at this time to come over here now, and look, they're still lit. Thank the Lord. This symbolizes the uniting of your two lives, your two families, even your two sets of friends in a distant sort of a way. But do keep your individual candles lit, please. This will show that you each maintain your own individuality, but then from this day forward, you will be both two persons, but one union. Marriage is a great mystery, and so I encourage you to keep this wonderful display in a prominent place in your home, to light it often, and to remember these words and these promises that you have made to one another. I think we ought to pray. God, thank you for this joyous day, for the light that has entered our life through your gifts, especially today of marriage. We're grateful for this gift. Please help this fine young couple and take them to the perfect place in this world for their love to take root and flourish. Let the light of their radiant love shine on all of those around them, May they be given strength for all they do and be given those inner gifts of trust, compassion, forgiveness, and truth, that they may live and grow together in love and peace. In the name of my Lord Jesus Christ, amen. Well, guys, we have made our vows, promised our promises, and exchanged the rings. Therefore, in the presence of Almighty God and before these witnesses present, I declare you officially to be husband and wife, and would state what the Lord Jesus said, what God has put together, let no one separate. Congratulations. I now invite you to both seal this day with a kiss worthy of this great occasion. Ryan, you may kiss your wife. Friends, thank you so much for joining us for this celebration of love. It's my privilege to present to all of you Mr. and Mrs. Ryan Deeney as they begin their new life as husband and wife.
Trying to fight this feeling, not quite sure what it is. You sit right there, left hand on the steering wheel driving, and I can't help but stare, 'cause you're so damn perfect. And I have so many things to say, but I just don't know how to word it, 'cause you're like a Tennessee summer, toes deep in the water, got me hotter than a fire. And you're like a fine wine sipping it, only need a little bit, and boy, I'm feeling it. I just wanna be the one you wanted, I just wanna give you all I've got, but I do it. Someone like you, when you get my wheels spinning out of this driveway running to you, and I can't help but smile when you look at me. I have so many things to say, but I just don't know how to say it, 'cause you're like a Tennessee summer, toes deep in the water, got me hotter than a fire. And you're like a fine wine sipping it, only need a little bit, and boy, I'm feeling it. I just wanna be the one you wanted, I just wanna give you all I've got, but I do it. Quite sure what it is, and you get my wheels spinning, and boy, you know I just can't help.
All right, coming in first, we have father of the bride, Victor, and America Gillen. Next through the door, we have mother of the bride, Carrie Gillen, escorted by godfather of the bride, Ernesto Gare. Next up, we have parents of the groom, Dave and Karen Deeney. And although they will not be walking out that door, we want to take a moment to first recognize grandmother of the bride, Dalia Pedre. At her seat, Dalia, please stand. Let's hear it for Dalia. And also grandfather of the groom, Ray Deeney. Where's Ray Deeney at? Make some noise for Ray. And now for our bridal party. First up, coming through the door, we have Claudia Deechin, escorted by Adam Hansen. Mm-hmm. right, next to the door, we have Dee Pirazzoli, escorted by Jeff Oskin. All right, help me welcome Jana Fabrizi, escorted by Damon Speciale. All right, next up, let's make some noise for Kelly LaFada, escorted by Eric Pabo. All right, next up, help me welcome Brittany Gattuso, escorted by Brad Baxa. All right, next to the door, we have Kendall Vaccaro, escorted by Bill Busy on Sports Buzzo. All right, put your hands together for Christy Fedeli, escorted by Kendrick Thomas. All right, now let's make some noise for Angela Fortuna, escorted by Victor Allen Gillen. Despacito, mami, yo sé que te va a encantar, mueve, dale, mami. Despacito. All right, let's make some noise for Valerie Aliff, escorted by her husband, Ryan Aliff. All right, next to the door, we have Michelle Edwards, escorted by her husband, Stephen Edwards, and they are with Ring Bearer and Flower Girl, Brandon and McKenna. All right, got a little baby shark in there. Let's keep it going for Kelsey Strushin, escorted by best man Scott Fireisen. All right, and last but not least, let's welcome our maid of honor, Lauren Gillen, escorted by best man, Jose Cherez. All right, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to ask everyone to please rise. Last but not least, I'd like to introduce you to the newest Mr. and Mrs. Ryan Deeney. One more time for our bride and groom. Guys, you can take your seats, but keep your attention over here at the center as our bride and groom are going to cut their wedding cake.
Down. Love and lust. Down. All of us.
Give me a run for my money. There was nobody, no one that would run me. So give me a run for my money. Spend bubbly, feeling lovely. Living lovely.
Keep it a whole one, don't got you, I got nothing. Hey, I got something.
I got something.
Hold up.
We gon' function. Hey, no assumptions. Hey, feeling like Tyson with it.
Knock it out twice, I'm with it. Only for the night, I'm kidding. Only for life, yeah. Only for life, yeah. Only for life, let's get it.
Hit that shoulder lean. I know what's coming over me. Backstroke oversee. I know what you need.
Already.
A trail through the trees to a cliff where Carolina meets the sky. Oh, and there's a view I just can't describe. No, we're not there yet, just a few more steps, baby, wait. Okay, you can open your eyes. This is it. Girl, I know that you've been waiting, talking to your friends, wondering if and wondering where and wondering when. Well, I've been waiting too, holding on to this ring, for the right words to say, for the right time and place for me. Talking about looking out, I can see forever. So take my hand, just take it in. This is the moment we won't forget. On top of the world here. is it. Yeah, this is it.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. As I look at my daughter, the bride, I can't help but reflect on all the years I was lucky enough to watch her grow.
Excuse me, Victor, one second. Hey, you savages in the back, I know most of you. Calm down, all right? Can we give the man the respect up here, all right? Please, everyone quiet. Everyone quiet, please.
Lucky enough to watch her grow and become the beautiful woman that she is today. She captured my heart on the very first day that she was born. And I become more and more in awe of her. As the years passed by, she was my little girl, my princess, and my ray of sunlight. And no matter what her age, she will always be those things to me. But today, as I watch her marry a wonderful man, I'm filled with pride. And I am confident that she and Ryan are about to embark on a wonderful journey filled with the love and happiness that can only come as a man and wife. May the two of you always treat each other with love, compassion, and kindness. Now, I ask you to join me today in congratulating the bride, Vanessa, and the groom, Ryan, and wishing them all the very best for a long and a happy life together.
I love you. That was beautiful. Thank you.
All right. Ryan, appreciate it. Welcome to the family.
Thank you. All right. Thank you for those kind words from Victor. And at this time, we're going to hand the mic over to our groom. Oh, Alice, other way.
Encore, here we go. First of all, we want to thank our parents, such a great support staff for us. Been through thick and thin with us, growing, you know, as far as growing up, and we love you to death. Yep. Second of all my out-of-towners, make some noise. Where's my out-of-towners at? We got people from Florida, California, Pennsylvania, Arizona, Wisconsin, Addison,
Schiller Park.
No, but we really do appreciate you coming out. I know it wasn't easy, and just looking around, it's overwhelming, and we're very blessed, and we are who we are because of all of you out there and everybody up here. So enjoy the night. Bars open all night, and it's going to be one night to remember.
Thank you guys very much. I won't ramble on. Again, family from close and far, everybody else, this is overwhelming. It really is it. That's why we picked that song, because we're blessed with family and friends. So thank you guys. Enjoy the open bar and food, and let's celebrate.
Hey guys, I'm Lauren, Vanessa's little sister and maid of honor, in case any of you don't know me. First and foremost, thank you all for coming and celebrating Vanessa and Ryan this evening. I appreciate it. She appreciates it. For those who do know me, you know I can't come in being mushy because it just isn't me. But I'm also very glad I'm going before Jose because, let's be honest, I'm not very funny. In true LG fashion, I would have loved to make this the roast of Vanessa, accompanied with a slideshow of some antipasto pictures with her best moments, but we'll keep it PG so I live. Ryan, I'm so glad she found someone that can tolerate her lengthy getting ready times, her obnoxious laugh, and her princess habits. I couldn't have dreamt up a nicer brother-in-law, so welcome to the fam. Vanessa, you annoy me daily, and I want to kill you about 75% of the time. But Mom, thanks for making her. She's the most valued pest and best friend wrapped in one that I'll have the pleasure of sharing life with forever. Vanessa is always who I turn to if I ever need cheering up. She's always the life of the party and has a positive attitude. In my opinion, the obvious but true secret to a successful relationship is always continuing to put in effort daily. Relationships are a gift, and we should all treat them as that, because we all know how hard it is to find a good person that genuinely loves you. So my advice to you is, through all the years to come, remember to have fun with one another, communicate, be romantic, devote quality time to your date nights, enjoy your journey together despite any lows, and grow together but never apart. I'd like to ask everyone to raise their glasses and join me in proposing a toast to the new Mr. and Miss Dini. Cheers, now let's party.
All right, thank you, Lauren. And coming up next, we're gonna have words from our two best men. First up is Scott Fireisen.
All right, everybody, how are we doing tonight? Okay, yes, the big night, the big Dini wedding. So excited to be here tonight. I am Scott Fireisen, for a life so big and such a great friend. Not just one best man can give the speech. There's got to be two of us up here. So Jose is giving us a hand as well. I've known Ryan for such a long time. I knew him four hairstyles ago. Think about that. But I've known him and his family for such a long time. I'd like to recognize his parents, Mr. and Mrs. Dini, David and Karen. It was awesome being at the house again today. I had so many great times there playing some pickup basketball games. And it's probably a good idea you took down that basketball hoop because it was going to get, we're going to have a 2-on-2 tournament there real quickly. So that worked out well. But the rest of the Dini family is so awesome. It was great to see Dini's sisters, Vanessa and Michelle. Great to see you guys again as well. One of the better events that we ever had, we went skydiving together, which was kind of wild. And I was thinking that tonight might be kind of like skydiving tonight. You know, there's a lot of anticipation building up for this big event. All these months since Dini got engaged and, you know, now we're into the event, and it's like, oh my God, I can't believe this is really happening. And then, at the end of it all, we're going to be trying to take it in and want to really soak it all up. And then there might be some of us that, you know, end up in a field and not even know how we got there, you know. Yeah, there'll be some guy with a camera saying, hey, way to go up there. Yeah, great job. So strap in. It's going to be a wild time. I first met Dini in the fourth grade. It was great to meet him. We met him on the recess park football game. It was a big deal when we were our age. He was the new guy in school, so it was great to meet him and great to make a new friend. My best friend had just moved away, so, you know, meeting Dini and getting to be a great friend with him was pretty awesome. We were fast friends throughout that, throughout grade school, throughout junior high, throughout high school. We went to college. And this guy joined a fraternity. What fraternity was that he joined? What fraternity was that, Jose?
Sig Tau, everybody. How you guys doing? For those of you that don't know me, my name is Jose. I've known Ryan since junior high, but before I give my roast speech, because he's about to get roasted, all right, if I could have everybody's attention, please. Everybody, if you could please just quiet down for a second. If you could, real quick, we are in the presence of a great man, a man that without his accomplishments in life, none of this would be happening. Grandpa Dini, if he could stand up right now. This Grandpa Dini right here is a great man. For those of you that don't know Grandpa Dini is a World War II veteran, a Marine at that. Fought in the Battle of Peleliu, and without him, the great legacy of the Dinis would not be here where it is today. So thank you, Grandpa Dini. Semper Fidelis, Marine. I met Ryan Dini in junior high, and I'll be honest with you, we didn't like each other. Legit, we were not friends. He was competitive as hell, and I was competitive as hell, and we did not like each other. And then, back in those days, that's when like Nirvana, Pearl Jam, and the Beastie Boys were cool, right? Ryan Dini, like Scotty said, actually had hair. Mrs. Dini can attest, he used to have the alfalfa haircut. He would plop a bunch of gel on his head and split it right down the middle. My man. But I gotta give him credit, the girls loved it. They loved it. We went to high school. We became friends. Why? Because I'm Mexican and I play soccer. And my best friend joined the soccer team. Boom. Now we are in the era of the Backstreet Boys and NSYNC. And the Frosted Tips are in. Everybody knows what I'm talking about. All you Addison guys, you all had Frosted Tips, you liars. You did. And guess what? My boy Ryan Dini, Frosted Tips all day. And the hair was spiky. He would poke your eye out. But I gotta give it to him. The girls loved it. The girls loved it. He had spiky tips and they were frosted. I can't roast him too much on that because I had frosted tips too. A Mexican with frosted tips. I'm sorry, it happened. I can't deny it. All right, so we go to college, right? My best friend goes to ISU. He says he's going to graduate in 4. I'm like, good luck, bro. I go to Evansville, Southern Indiana, to go play soccer. Right? We go away. We come back. And next thing I know, my best friend has turned into a frat guy. Sig taw everything. Yep. Sig taw baseball hats. Sig taw hoodies. Sig taw t-shirts. Sig taw everything. I got a formal. I got this. I got that. Everybody knows what I'm talking. They're all laughing up here. You see that? Because they know it's true. And Ryan's like, bro, that wasn't me. That wasn't me. I'm like, dude, you were a sig taw walking guy. He's a walking billboard of sig taw. It got so bad. I was busting his balls so bad. He told me, hey, bro, listen, you can't talk to me about sig taw. You have one sig taw left. And I was like, all right, man. I will not make fun of you at sig taw until the day you get married. And guess what, folks? Here we are. So, if I could get this left side of the room to say sig and this right side to say taw, because this is the last one I got. I can't do sig taw no more. All right? Everybody on the left, sig. Taw. Sig. Taw. Sig! Ta! That was it. That's it. One last sig ta, right? All right. So, it's only fitting. All right, I'm going to try and make this fast because I know everybody wants to party. So, like I told you before, right? My buddy is marrying a Latina. Where are my Latinas at? I know there's a lot of female Latinas. He's about to marry a Latina. He's crazy. He's crazy. So I did some research for him. I did some research, and I found, like, the top 10 things to look after when you're about to marry a Latina. And ladies, where are my Latinas at? Is he in for a world or what? Oh, yeah. He don't even know. He don't even know. He's going to wake up to, like, hey, where's the chorizo at, honey? Where are the scrambled eggs? And she and Ryan's going to be like, huh? I'm a dini. What are you talking about? So real quick, here we go. A guide for marrying a Latina. Number one, when she starts yelling at you in Spanish, you better run, bro. You better run. Number two, get used to it, my friend, but Latinas are loud, right? They're loud. They're loud when they're happy, and they're loud when they're pissed. They're loud all the time. Yeah, I see all Latinas that are like, oh, my God, he's so right. I'm so loud. Yeah, they're loud all the time, all the time. Number three, you better learn to dance, bro. You better fake it till you make it. Number four, you better have a good memory because there's a lot of cousins, there's a lot of aunts, there's a lot of tios, there's a lot of tias, there's my cousin, sister's babies, aunts, uncle's cousin, and we're still related. But he does have an advantage because, for those of you that know, the dinis, they roll deep. Yeah, where are the dinis at? Yeah. The dinis roll deep. For all the Cubans and all the Mexicans in this crowd, you got a competition because the dinis roll countrywide. They roll deep, real deep. From Arizona to Wisconsin, you better be careful. All right, here we go. Number five, you better be ready for your nickname, bro, because all Latin families, they give you a nickname, and you probably already have one. Yeah. Yeah, look at the ants. They're like, yeah, we got a name for him. Yeah, we got a nickname for him. Here we go. Here's another one. Tamales, tortas, tacos, Cuban sandwiches, pozole, and quesadillas are now your best friend. They are now your best friend. So you better get used to it, and you better start working out with all the kids you teach PE to. Latinas, where are my Latinas at? You guys are territorial. Territorial, yeah, you know what I'm talking about. Ryan Dini might as well be carrying a Cuban flag and a Mexican flag, but everyone's going to know Miss Dini's watching. Yep. All right, last but not least, the time in the Latin world is about an hour and a half behind, so I'm really surprised we're still going on time right now. Surprisingly, Lauren showed up on time today. You're about an hour and a half behind on the time zone, so you better get used to it. No, folks, but in all seriousness, I want to thank Renessa and Ryan for choosing Scotty and I to be up here and giving the best man speech. And I owe Ryan a lot. Leave it to your best man to find you your future wife. Ryan and Vanessa introduced me to my future wife, Brittany Gattuso. So I owe this guy a hell of a lot. I love you, man. Thank you. If I could have everybody please raise your glass in a toast to Ryan and Vanessa. May God bless you, and you guys live a long and beautiful life together. I love you guys. Cheers, everybody. Have a great time.
Eras niña de largos silencios y ya me querías bien. Tu mirada buscaba la mía, jugabas a ser mujer. Pocos años ganados al tiempo, vestidos con otra piel. Y mi vida que nada esperaba, también te quería bien. Te extrañaba ya tanto, que al no verte a mi lado, ya soñaba con volver. Entre tanto te estaba inventando de niña mujer. Y esa niña de largos silencios volaba tan alto que mi mirada quería alcanzarla y no la podía ver. Paraba en el tiempo pensando que no debería crecer, pero el tiempo me estaba engañando, mi niña se hacía mujer. La quería ya tanto que al no verla a mi lado ya sabía que la iba a perder. Y es que el alma le estaba cambiando de niña mujer. La quería ya tanto que al no verla a mi lado ya sabía que la iba a perder. Y es que el alma estaba cambiando de niña mujer. Claro, claro, claro.
All right, guys, make some noise for the lovely Vanessa and her father, Victor. Thank you, guys. And if we could bring on our groom. Where's our groom at and his lovely mother, Karen?
Don't go away from me. Oh, I'm
She's the sky that holds the clouds. She's the lady of our house. We all need her, but no one more than me. Oh, the wars would all be over, 'cause she'd raise us all as friends. And no one would ever wonder if somebody wanted them. We'd walk on grass that's greener, and the dishes would all be cleaner. If the world had a mother like mine, ooh, like mine, yeah.
All right, let's hear it for Ryan and his lovely mother, Karen.